Hello, I'm Ann Johans. I'm an Extension Program Specialist with Iowa State University Extension and Outreach. And in today's video, we're going to walk through the Web Soil Survey website from USDA NRCS to show how to map attractive Iowa farmland and find the weighted average CSR2 value for the designated area. Let's get started. The corn suitability rating is an index of long-term potential row crop productivity. The CSR2 is an updated method from the original CSR and was released in 2013. For specific details on CSR2, I'd highly recommend you visit the soil and land use website that is listed there for history and details on the formula used in calculating CSR2. CSR2 information available through the USDA NRCS Web Soil Survey is the nation's official source of soil survey information. There is a wide range of information available through Web Soil Survey, but for today's purposes, we'll focus only on the steps to find CSR2 information. To begin, we'll visit the website. This is the homepage for Web Soil Survey. From here, we'll click on the green button for Start WSS. On the screen that appears, there's methods for finding attractive farmland along the left-hand side. You could search by address, state and county, soil survey area, latitude, longitude, but today we're going to focus on this one that says section, township, and range. And across the top of the US map, you're going to find some options to help you manipulate through the map, either zooming in and out, panning, zooming back to the US map, moving back and forth as you make changes to the map, measuring distance. But really today we want to focus on these two buttons right here that are small red shapes with AOI in very small letters underneath them that stands for area of interest. This rectangular one is if you wanted to map out a pretty standard shape. And then this kind of irregular shape is if we want to map around something, and we're going to use that one today. So to get started, we're going to click on this arrow right here with section, township, and range to expand that menu. And then we're going to choose Iowa from the pull down menu. Then if you would know your section, township, and range, if that's the method that you're going to use, we're going to type those in next, either from your plat book or a farm description is where you might find those numbers. So we click on those, we're going to enter in only numbers, no letters. And then you can see that zoomed in to the specific area that I just entered. And the next steps, we're going to create that area of interest. So I'm going to click this button for the irregular shape. And to get started, we're going to click once in the corner of the property in question, and it's going to start to draw an outline of that property. And so we come over to the next corner, we click once just down and up with our mouse. And then I'm going to map around this acreage right here. And so we're going to just click as we make corners around that acreage. And if you aren't happy with how it's is turning out, you just redo it. It's a pretty simple process once you have done it a couple times. And so once you get to the end though, we're going to double click. And so it's going to create that area of interest. And let's say that I wanted to get a little more detailed, or I wasn't very happy with how those corners turned out. And so we can just start over. We don't have to go back or restart the web soil survey. We can just do that all on this same screen right here. And so let's say I just want to get those corners a little bit cleaner. And again, I get to the very end and I'm going to double click. Now that I'm happy with my area interest, maybe I just want to double check how many acres I have, or just, you know, maybe today I just wanted to see the soil types. And so across the top, we have some more menus, and this one next to our area of interest is soil map. And what that's going to do is going to outline the different soils on that piece of property. And on the left-hand side, you can see the different soil types. You could click on them for a little bit more description of each one if you are interested in that. And then you can also see the total acres. So in my example, I have about 143 acres. Now, this is great information, but we want to get just a little bit more detailed, right, in our search today. And so we're going to go to this next tab over that says Soil Data Explorer. And this has a huge amount of information associated with these soil types. But today we're going to click on vegetative productivity. And then under that menu, there is a menu that says Iowa Corn Suitability Rating, CSR2, Iowa. I click on that, and there's already some defaults checked there. And so we can just choose this button that says View Rating. And that opens up a really nice shaded map of that soil property. And we can then scroll down on the same page, and there's our soils data as our soil types, the CSR2 rating right here in this rating column for each soil type, and then the area acres of each of those soil types in our area of interest. The thing that this table does not do is give us the weighted average CSR2 that tells us the CSR2 value for the property as a whole, right? Not just each individual soil type. Now you can calculate that manually, or Iowa State University Extension on our Ag Decision Maker website. We have a handy tool that can help you maybe save you a few steps, especially if you're gonna be mapping out several properties, this might be the way to go. So on our Ag Decision Maker website, we can go over to Whole Farm. There's a section for land values, and then we can see there's a submenu for corn suitability ratings. And if we click on those buttons, it'll take us just farther down on that same page. And you can see there's some information with a little background information on CSR2, as well as a link to that soil and land use website. But the decision tool, you can click right here on this green button, and that's going to open up that Excel file for you. Once that opens up, you're going to want to click across the top. There's going to be a button that says Enable Editing. That'll allow you to make changes to that spreadsheet. And you can see there's an example spreadsheet. And then there's also a tab for blank. And that's the one that we're going to start on. And we're going to want to type in just a little bit of detail so that if you would save this on your computer or print it out, you know what property that you're looking at. So we know I had 143 acres. Maybe I know that there's about 135 acres of cropland. Just helps me detail that piece of property. And so back on the CSR2 website, we're gonna go ahead and just start on the first row of that data. We're gonna copy that. You could also manually enter in some of this information, but we wanna save those steps today. So we can right click and hit copy, or we could hit Control C on our keyboard. If I come back to that decision tool, I'm going to right click and I'm going to choose my second paste option to match the destination, just makes it paste in there a little bit cleaner. And then you can come down here and you can see that the spreadsheet calculated the weighted average corn suitability rating for this property as 80 on that scale of 5 to 100. So with that, if you want to go back, you can go back to Web Soil Survey and redo those steps. Or the other option, you could save this decision tool on your computer, or you can print it out. And on Web Soil Survey, you can also do print out a really nice map. You can go up here to the button that says printable version. You will likely need to allow or disable your pop-up blocker. And you hit that button, you can hit view, and it's gonna open up a PDF file. There you go, with a nice map of the property. I could save this on my computer. I could print it out. This has the soil map, the legend with a little detail, as well as that table with the various soil types and their CSR2 rating. So with that, I thank you for watching today's video, and I hope that it gets you farther on your path to learning more about the soils on your farm. Have a good day.